Hello everyone, Narcissist Free Almost here, and today I'm adding control to my series Narcissists Are Dangerous People. So we all know that the narcissist is all about control, but what does that really look like? Anybody can be controlling. We all know someone who likes things a certain way and might be inflexible to a degree. But that's not the same thing at all when I use the terms controlling and narcissist together. Not even close. First, imagine control as an umbrella with all other abusive terms under it. All of those terms are some form of control. Manipulation, of course, gaslighting, ignoring, lying, love bombing, triangulation, smear campaigns, playing the victim, revenge, shaming, victim blaming, intimidation, threatening, lying, hoovering. Well, I might have missed a few here, but I think you get the general idea. Now, the word control looks a lot bigger when it comes to a narcissist, doesn't it? So their modus operandi is to use everyone around them to garner their wants and desires. Often they are living in a fantasy bubble, delusions of grandeur, if you will. So to make this delusion come true or manifest, it's not enough for them to use wishful thinking to make it happen. They have to accomplish this by controlling everyone around them. I know it's hard to believe, and I would have never believed it myself had I not lived it for over 2 decades. Heck, even when I saw it unfold right in front of my face, I still couldn't believe it. I just couldn't get it through my head that seemingly sane adults acted like this, and worse yet, got away with it. But they do. For example, the first year the narc and I were never married, the narc decided he wanted to get into my computer. And as a side note, I say we were never married because he refused to move in after the wedding and live together. I had no idea what was going on, and I was thoroughly humiliated, but I was still a busy person raising 2 kids, so I barely had time to think about it. So these were the games he was playing while I was totally distracted. Anyway, he knew absolutely nothing about computers, so he enlisted my next-door condo neighbor to spy on me. We had been neighbors for over 10 years. In fact, I knew her before I knew him. So this is where it gets really weird. We weren't really hard and fast friends, though. Just friendly neighbors looking out for each other, or so I thought. Anyway, she concocts this elaborate story of how she's afraid for her and her son because some guy threatened her or something like that, and asks if she could stay over for the night. Not knowing anything about narcissism or that people acted like this at all, I of course invited her to stay the night. I trusted her and wanted to help. I go to work in the morning and come home for lunch to let the dog out, and what do I see? The condo neighbor, still in her pajamas, sprawled out on my sofa watching TV. Obviously, she didn't expect me home for lunch. By the way, did I mention we shared a wall? She only had to walk about 10 steps to her own front door. So I'm surprised, and she's surprised, and starts explaining how she was being lazy and how she's sorry she left a mess in the upstairs bathroom. By the way, that's next to my bedroom where I kept my computer, and she hopes it's okay she gave her son a bath. I'm thinking, what? Now I'm confused, which, by the way, is how I spent my entire life around a narcissist. Oh, sure, I say I don't mind, but I'm thinking to myself, why did she just mosey on over to her own place and give her son a bath there? It was daylight, after all, and the threat had passed, right? Well, things certainly weren't adding up. As she's gathering her things to leave, I go upstairs and look around. Funny, nothing's out of place in the bathroom, no water, no wet towels. Doesn't look like anyone took a bath, so what was that all about? I look at my computer on my desk, and nothing's out of place there either, but I'm highly suspicious at this point. With her pathetic story of, in case things looked out of place, in case she was snooping around, right? She was just too comfortable and didn't think I would be home until late and thought she had more time. I found this a way to figure out later because I don't want to believe the worst. It did take me a while to figure this out because I was absolutely oblivious to narcissism and all it entails. Plus, I always believed the best in people. Surely my neighbor wasn't doing what I thought she was doing. Years go by when I finally realized, because it's like in my face now, that the condo neighbor was not only an overt narcissist, the loud and obnoxious kind, but was also working with NARC 2 against me. The narcissist would have figured her out right from the beginning, which he obviously did and intended on using her. And although she was a willing participant, because narcs just can't help themselves, she was still being controlled. He would have fed her some bullshit lies and manipulated her into this situation. Buying a hook, line, and sinker, and knowing the condo neighbor like I did, she would probably have thought this was fun, since she didn't have much of a life of her own, and she was very envious. But the fact remains, she was still being controlled. He was controlling her perceptions, and thereby, and this is key, controlling her behavior. Thus, all in an effort to control me. Control all around for everyone, right? That's how pathological narcissists work. But let's take a moment and contrast the situation with a normal person, or let's say me, by the way. I'm not exactly normal, but I like to think I would have handled this situation a lot differently. First, I probably would have been offended and met the request with a flat no way. I'm not going to make up a story to spy on my neighbor for you, and I can't even believe you asked me to do that. And if you wanted to know something about your wife, ask your wife. And then I would have walked away, ending the relationship. On top of that, I would have probably gone to my longtime neighbor and told them what was going on. That's how skilled and two-faced NARC 2 is. He knows how I am, given the example, and was always careful not to let on what he was saying and doing to other people, because he knows I absolutely wouldn't stand for that behavior and would have immediately ended our relationship. His mirroring was worthy of an Oscar. What's extraordinary to me is that other people went along with his evil antics. His manipulation skills were that of a brain surgeon, and about 98% of the people I knew were so easily led astray. Only one threw me little hints here and there, but the rest were like lambs to the slaughter. They used to surprise me, but given what we've been through the last 3 years, it doesn't surprise me any longer, and I completely understand why things like Nazi Germany happen now. To tell the NARC condo neighbor that you were being manipulated to betray your trusting neighbor probably wouldn't do any good, since she was a NARC herself and there would be no shame about it. But a normal person would be pissed that they were lied to, and not only that, mad at themselves for making an ass out of themselves. For who? For what? Finally, the NARC was all about controlling me to further his agenda du jour. But to control me, he had to control everyone else by manipulating their perceptions of me to do his bidding or to persuade them to abuse me in one way or another. Because really, at the bottom of all of this is cowardice. The NARC was getting other people to treat me like he wanted to treat me to my face. And on the flip side, he was controlling me to manage his image. That is, he would do nice things for me so I would praise him, talking him up to others, so he appeared to be like the normal, responsible, generous, doting husband who eventually becomes the put-upon victim of me. And that would be when he decided to discard me, of course. Dizzy yet? He was basically having his cake and eating it too. But the truth was, he hated me. In fact, I truly believe he hates women, period. And there are some deep-rooted psychological reasons for that, which I do believe might even be the cause of his disorder. But for the sake of time again, I'll let you ponder what you think those reasons might be. Sadly, it was all just a scam. He was just using me to build and maintain a facade of the hero victim. Hero to me, so I would talk him up to other people, and other people would think he was like this really nice, normal guy. And then behind my back, he's playing the abused victim of me, telling everyone how awful I am to him, and he's getting all this sympathy and pity. And meantime, I have no idea this is going on. It was over-the-top ambient abuse because I couldn't understand why people were looking at me or whispering or not talking to me. He, like I said, he was having his cake and eating it too. And in order to accomplish this so effectively over time, he needed to control everyone's perception, which inevitably led to controlling their behavior, whether they knew it or not, and they most of the time didn't know it. So how powerful this must make a person feel, secretly screwing with everyone's heads to get them to do things they would never do if they knew the truth. So the bottom line is we were all played, and people are still being played because that's what pathological narcissists do. And there just might be a broader lesson here as well to avoid being manipulated. And that would be to remember, when someone is controlling your perceptions, they are inevitably going to control your behavior. So ask yourself, are your perceptions being manipulated? Something to think about for sure.